What's going on, everybody? We are back, and we have a special guest today, Mr. Ronald Campbell. You may recognize him as the viral TikTok grandpa. He was doing this thing, and I'm going to go ahead and introduce our co-hosts, or let them introduce themselves, and then we're going to get to some info, and we will get to the interview. So,
what's going on, y'all? It's D.I.R.E.
What up? It's JP, the big fella.
Shelby the Great.
Ronald Campbell.
That's right. So, it's always a lot going on in America.
It's America.
Yes. Well, apparently, a guy known as I Am Suave Xavier on Instagram called a gym pretending to be Kevin Hart to get a membership. So, I need y'all to listen to this, okay? Listen.
When I tell you, oh, my God. This dude. This weird?
Nah.
Yeah. Oh my God.
Press 1 for new members.
I'm host of Fitness Racing 5. This is Ebony. How may I direct your call?
I was actually hoping to talk to someone about a gym membership.
Yes.
You can talk to me about a gym membership.
Okay, Ebony, this is Kevin Hart. I'm in town for the weekend. I was actually thinking about getting a gym membership, just some short term. I don't need nothing long, maybe like 2 or 3 days. I'm only in town for a few days, so I'm actually going to fly out soon, so I was actually thinking, what, like, do you guys do celebrity discounts?
Celebrity discount?
Yes, ma'am.
Come
on, Ebony, it's Kevin Hart. Me and you, I know you already feel the vibe.
Oh, my gosh, is this Kevin Hart for real?
This is actually Kevin Hart. I wouldn't lie about that.
Oh, my God, this is Kevin Hart.
It is Kevin Hart. How you doing?
It's him. Oh, my gosh.
It is. How you doing?
It's him.
Look, and then he also did Cat Williams, amongst others. Listen to this.
Confession time, I can say whatever I want.
This is Kevin
Hart. All right, cool. Cat's out the bag, people. I will never work with Cat Williams. That's why I've never done a movie with him. I don't want to be in the same room as him. I can't stand him.
Yeah.
I just can't stand him. This is confession time, right? Ain't nobody gonna see this. Okay, if they do see it, you know I'm a snitch, right? Anyway, y'all thought it was Corona that got me out? No, son, it was Donald Trump, stupid. Trump had my back, and I fight everybody. I'm the king of New York.
That's 6'9".
Okay, so let me just say publicly, I've never thought Kevin Hart was all that funny. Never even really thought he was a true comedian.
No way.
Like anyway, all he does is bitches and moan. Hell, I got hoes that'll do that for free.
That's amazing.
Yes. So check out his page. He has, as you heard, Cat Williams, Donald Trump, Lil Wayne, Terrence Howard. He does all of them.
Nah, he killed them. He killed them.
I would like to hear him do Terrence Howard.
What's that other guy that was on the? He's better than that dude that was on Pharaoh, whatever.
He's better than him, dude.
Seriously.
Oh, really?
Yes. That's crazy.
Pharaoh, good.
Yeah. He's good. But that right there is nuts. This dead on. He got all the cadence.
I'm trying to. Is that the younger, like, black guy that was, like, in barbershops doing that? Like, I seen a couple videos of a guy that was in a barbershop.
Everybody
was trying to egg him on to do the impersonation.
I don't think that's him.
Oh, yeah, because this is the first time me actually seeing him.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah. It's. He was really good too.
Yeah,
it's, I don't think that's him.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, this is the first time me actually seeing him. So,
did he get the discount?
Yeah.
I don't know.
What, in the longer when they kept trying to get him to come up there, she kept saying, "Come up," and then he was like, "Yeah, Dwayne is coming with me," and then she paused and was like, "Dwayne, The Rock." She was going nuts, like, oh my God, you about to bring the Rock up there. Yeah, man, that's crazy. That dude is nuts.
It is crazy.
That's so crazy.
So, today the Shade Room recognizes Eddie Murphy for his previous music career. Remember the song Party All the Time? Y'all remember that?
Unfortunately.
Come on.
And I bet y'all didn't know that he had a song with Michael Jackson, because actually, I had never heard this.
You never heard this?
Yeah.
Man, they thought they was jamming in this video.
He was trying to do his pop career thing.
And then, of course, you know, he did his song in Dreamgirls.
Oh, he was jamming in Dreamgirls. That's my movie.
The volume kind of low on this. Yep. So for you youngins, that's what it is.
Step your game up on your info.
Look, so Kim Kardashian posts a picture of her and her sisters at Benihana. And so Kylie asked her to please delete it. So she asked, so Kim goes and says, you want me to diddy crop you out? Diddy crop. Remember that picture? It was some picture with the celebs. And I can't remember who they cropped out. But they had cropped out one of the people in the picture. I can't. This was a few years ago.
She's talking about the Jay-Z brunch? Where somebody was left that. Out?
Yeah.
Okay, I know. Okay.
So she like, you want me to diddy crop you out? She was like, yeah, like that'll work. My thing is, Kylie, we know how you look before surgery, boo. We know.
She probably ain't get that deal from Benihana's that they got. She probably like, no, I'm not about to promote them. Because that's all they doing anyway. They going to Benihana's because they probably bought one.
Right.
Or maybe got some percentage in it. I mean, it makes sense.
I mean, yeah, that's a thought.
Yeah. Business, baby.
So 50 Cent was being 50 Cent, okay? And he shares the picture of Dr. Dre. It says, Dr. Dre's estranged wife, Nicole Young, wants $2 million in monthly support. So his caption says, these bitches be crazy. How do you even ask for $2 million a month? And then he throws his hashtags in there. So I guess his daughter says, Dr. Dre's daughter, says, haha, coming from an ugly, washed up, early 2000s rapper who filed for bankruptcy and is only envious of my family's wealth and lifestyle. Have fun spending the rest of your savings on steroids. Fuck you.
Whoa.
And ain't that crazy? So he responds, Dr. Dre's daughter just told me to shut the fuck up. Laugh out loud. Hashtag stars. Hashtag brains on cognac. Hashtag Lesha Maduri or whatever that is. He is crazy. So 50 Cent, you know he going to get his coins. He's going to promote his stuff. I mean, whatever you throw at him, he going to spin it or he's going to make you look stupid. He going to do something. So that's what he did.
It's just so many things about that story that I could talk about.
I have so many questions.
Right.
Okay. I have so many questions.
Well, go on ahead and let's hear it.
From the $2 million to 50 Cent filing bankruptcy to, man, it's just so much. He's not broke. Let's be clear.
Yeah, that's true. He's definitely not broke.
And that bankruptcy was a long time ago. That was some years ago. And wasn't he just trying to hide some money?
That don't mean you broke.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's not what that means at all.
How many times has Trump filed bankruptcy?
Exactly. Shoot, I mean, I think they was calling him the bankruptcy king at one point in time.
He started off filing bankruptcy.
Yeah.
Man.
With a $200 million loan from your parents, I understand.
With a small $200 million. Small.
Small. Small loan from my dad. Either $200 million or two. It's probably two. $2
million. So what about this $2 million a month, though?
I mean, she's divorcing him. They tried to accuse her of embezzlement, too.
Is the kids still? Oh, well, I guess the kids probably grown. Never mind.
Yeah, they older.
I don't know, man. That is a lot.
But is she staying in the company? Because she on his paperwork. I think that's a lot if you staying.
Yeah.
With, like, if you stay on paperwork. Like, if he's not taking you off, I think $2 million is a lot.
You know she's trying to claim like she made Dr. Dre.
I'm aware. I mean, she probably assisted in the making of. They've been locked down for a long time.
Yeah, she probably did. Him go in a certain direction financially and business wise and stuff like that. Yeah.
$2 million a
month, girl. Okay.
She probably looking at it from a business standpoint. I mean, $2 million a month. When it comes to spousal support, it's more about sustaining that lifestyle that you got her accustomed with. So $2 million, I don't see that being
a month.
But I'm saying
not a year.
Man, you crazy?
If she is that's what I'm saying. If she is still $2 million
a month,
the paperwork though, where she is collecting an income,
right.
I feel like $2 million is a stretch. If you are removing her, then yes, you still have to maintain this certain lifestyle.
Right.
We know that as we get married, we know
you
that
have like, to or
that's
you
what they
want
say.
To.
No, you have to.
By law.
When you sign that paper, that's what you then y'all. That's you have to whatever
prenup.
If you were being taken care of a certain way, they have to maintain that lifestyle for you. Mm-hmm. There can be a time like a a time lapse on it, but they have to maintain their lifestyle.
Yeah.
So that's what I'm. That's what my point is. Like, she is on paperwork as like part owner of a lot of things that he has done. So if she stays there, then I think $2 million is a stretch.
Right.
You're still generating the income.
Right.
But if she's not, then that's on them.
Isn't Jeff Bezos the Amazon guy?
Half.
Okay. Huh?
She gets half.
I thought she got like a certain amount.
No, she
like
gets half. She gets half.
Okay, so what is half of what he got? Is it $2 million a month?
No. I'm saying half of what he's worth. So she gets $400 million.
Okay.
So why don't old girl get half of what he's worth?
How about with $2 million a month for how long? Till she die?
I don't know. It sounds like it need to be 6 months because, I mean, dog.
It shouldn't be at all.
What is this about?
But now, and they could do that. They could say, you know, this is the time frame, maybe 6 months or something like that for you to kind of get your shit together.
Tiger Woods' wife got 850, right? Or 250, something like that?
She got like 200, like 300, something like that, million.
Mm-hmm. You know what? Before I go on.
No, she got the majority of it because of kids, yeah.
Before I go on to the next point, I just want to say this. Young ladies, let me tell you something. I know y'all think y'all got that WAP, okay? But you're not going to end up like Dr. Dre's wife. Please go ahead and get you something. Get your own. You know, entrepreneurship is a thing. You know, 2020 has opened the doors with the coronavirus. Go ahead and cultivate something. Because just sitting up trying to be cute, throwing some WAP around, baby, one day it's gonna be some dap. It's gonna be some dry ass pussy, and it ain't gonna get a damn thing. So you better go on ahead and get what you need to get. I'm just saying.
That's it.
I'm just saying. I'm gonna learn you something today. Ain't that what they use? I'm gonna learn you something today. So Tory Lanez released his album Daystar yesterday on the 25th. He is donating a portion of the proceeds to Breonna Taylor Foundation. So my thing is that his way of trying to redeem himself from the Megan Thee Stallion thing?
Man, you know, I don't know nothing about their situation. I really don't. I don't know, and I do not care, because this Hollywood thing is just, it's beyond bizarre. Who does not go to jail for shooting someone?
That's what I'm saying.
Who don't?
Well,
it's insane to assume that this is real life. Something
that's when you have to question the authenticity of a lot of these stories,
man. Absolutely.
Like, come on, man.
Come on. I mean, a firing a weapon,
and you're not even a big star.
That's what. Not at all. Not at all.
Well, we gonna get into that too. So let's see what Rick Ross had to say.
Poor decision, brother. Dropping that project just out of respect for Breonna Taylor. Just out of respect for Breonna Taylor, brother. We gotta respect these sisters. That ain't how you address the accusations.
So that was his rebuttal. So here go what Tory Lanez said. He said, Rick Ross, I respect you too much as a black man to disrespect you in these times. However, I went out and marched 9 days straight for Breonna Taylor in your city. I didn't see the boss out there once. Also, stop tagging your endorsements and posts about her. It's a poor decision. Mm. Well, I guess he went on here and told Rick Ross to sit down.
Now, both of them, you know, both can be true.
Yeah, okay, I'll give you that.
They both can be true.
I'll give you that. Will Smith turned 52 years old yesterday. Damn. So happy birthday to him. And T.I. turned 40 yesterday. Damn. Happy birthday to him.
They look about the same age. That's the crazy part.
They do.
Will Smith is the best looking 52-year-old.
He is, man. He goes right now.
Well, you know, dye goes a long way. Hair dye and stuff like that.
I mean, you know, he look good, great too, though. Like when it's little.
But you can tell it's the skin. You know what I mean? Yeah, the skin looks good. You know.
Yeah, but you know them Smiths probably cooking something up in the kitchen.
Yeah.
You know, they
with a flick of the wrist.
They got entanglement juice. They rubbing it on their face, and it's keeping them young. So Mariah Carey is coming out with some drama. You know, what would life be without drama? We talk so much trash about drama, but seriously.
Boring.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Let's keep it real. I mean, because if everything was perfect, everybody lived in a white house with a picket fence with two dogs and three children, and, you know, everyone took their trash out and didn't leave it on the frickin' grass, and their cars didn't... Never mind. But, you know, then... Right. What would life be? It would be the same mundane thing. So we've got to have
drama. But see, drama, I ain't going to push. I'm just gonna add a little bit.
Okay.
But drama is like salt.
Yeah.
You just want a dab of it. You don't, too much of it will fuck your food up. You know what I mean? So it's just, you know, I mean, just a dab. Just a, you know.
So what they saying, ladies, is we know you love these men that be in the streets, but...
A
shootout is only like damn on TV. You don't want to be in the shootout.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Some of y'all like the shootout. So I just thought I'd put that out there. So Mariah Carey claims. Oh, sorry, y'all. It's hard when you're trying to use this thing. I'm gonna let her say it though.
Never spoken about it. I did feel like I was held captive in that relationship.
Hold on.
Backseat of the police car. It's a vivid memory. I have never spoken about it. I did feel like I was held captive in that relationship.
So she claims she was allegedly drugged and offered to pimp and offered to a pimp at 12 years old by her sister in her new memoir. So that's what she's about to drop a diamond on. Hey, guess who's in it? Oprah.
Okay, of course.
Who would have thought? It had to be Oprah Gale, right? They love all the mess. I don't know what's going on with Mariah Carey. Let me tell you something. Since I was a kid, I've always loved Mariah Carey. I used to try to hit her high notes. my cousin will tell you about that. She, you know, I was successful a few times doing so. I can't do it now. But this woman, this beautiful, talented woman, she can't keep a man to save her life.
Because she's crazy as hell.
But they won't say that. You can't get Nick Cannon to say that. You ain't gonna get none of them. I don't know if she puts an NDA on them or what she does.
I mean, I don't know. I mean, considering that Tommy Mottola is her ex-husband, I shut the fuck up too.
Yeah.
I just think Hollywood do something to you, especially when you've been there for a long time. You just you come numb to a lot of regular things. Mm-hmm. And like I said, some people would definitely consider her crazy.
For sure. Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, she married Tommy Mottola. You gotta be fucking crazy to marry. You're that young? How young she was? You know what I mean?
She was trying to make it.
But not that way.
She made it.
She said, Mass is gonna help me.
Damn.
So,
that was her vision of love.
That was a good one. Your boy Kanye West, he arrived in Haiti yesterday morning. He's rumored to be meeting with President Jovenel Moïse. So, I don't know what he's got going on. Moïse, whatever his name is.
Moïse.
M-O-I-S-E. For all you grammar people that like to check in the comments, you go ahead and do the homework on that.
That sounds like a moist ass nigga.
You put that T. You put that T on there.
Yeah, he does.
Moist.
Yeah, that moist. That moist. Oh my
bad. I didn't mean to say it like that. But what the hell is Kanye trying to do in Haiti? He said they don't want me in America, so I'm gonna try to negotiate with Haiti. Listen, I don't have no issues with Kanye. I want to be clear though. I think we need to still support our brothers and sisters. We're so quick to throw them away. But if you was from the Caucasus Mountain, you would not be doing that. They stand by each other through hook and crook. If nothing else, they just shut up. If they don't agree, they just wave their hand. You know how they say in church, if I can't say nothing, I'm going to wave my hand. Some of y'all need to learn to wave your hand and shut the fuck up. Seriously. I mean, you know, we got to support our people. I know I'm getting a little raw this week, but this is what we're going to do. So
you ain't saying nothing they don't need to hear.
Yeah. I'm just for real though, because we're all think about all the times you did something stupid, said something stupid. Now magnify being in the public light. Somebody got a camera on you and a recorder all the time. They think you was crazy as hell too. I'm sure I've done some crazy things. I'm sure they'd be like, you know that girl, that little yellow girl with the light eyes. She's crazy. I'm sure. You know what I'm saying? So let's just keep it 100 for real. Breonna Taylor's family. She's calling out. They're calling out the justice system. I'm gonna play a little clip. As they should. Yep. Sorry, y'all.
The judge who signed the search warrant failed her. The terrorist who broke down her door failed her. Mm. The system as a whole has failed her. You didn't just rob me of my and my family. You robbed the world of a queen. Mm. A queen willing to do a job that most of us could never stomach to do. A queen willing to build up anyone around her. A queen who was starting to pave her path. I hope you never have to know the pain of knowing your child is in need and help and you're not able to get them. I hope you never hear the sounds of seeing someone cry and beg for your child to get help and she never receives help. Those cries was ignored. I hope you never know the pain of your child being murdered 191 days in a row. Tamika Palmer.
Jesus. What's y'all thoughts about that?
Where to begin? Hell.
You know, it made me think about that, but that one little girl that died. Remember, a lot of people probably don't remember the backstory behind it, but remember when those cops bust in the door and they shot that kid that was asleep in Detroit? Mm-hmm. And that was girl. Actually, wasn't that the first show? No, not the first show. I think it was, whatever. It was the show.
Was it First 48?
First 48, yeah. First 48. When First 48 came in and they said that the producers was making them do all this, that, and the third or whatever. When they kicked in the door, they shot the girl. And I can't really remember what happened in that case, but it would be similar, the outcome. You know what I mean? I don't know if they got money or whatever. You know, I know Breonna Taylor situation, you know, it's very, very similar to that situation. It's made me think about that. But I mean, you know, if you think that the police is going to be held accountable for what they do, then you kind of don't know politics. You don't know the justice system. You don't know, you know, the laws.
What was it that they was just charged with, though?
Yeah.
For the
shots he missed.
Yeah, for shooting. Yeah.
So we can't charge him for a life, but we can charge him for some walls.
Yeah, I mean, because they're kind of there to protect the property, and they damage, you know, I mean, that's really what they're there
so
for.
So, the apartment complex. Like,
there's a lot of cases in criminal.
Oh, yeah, this criminal justice guy right here.
I had
here.
Never heard this before.
There's a lot of criminal cases where somebody didn't get charged for the criminal act, but later on got civil action sued against them. It happens a lot.
I mean, the civil action part of it, yeah, but like, God damn, y'all, come on now.
Yeah, now in a just world, and in the right or wrong world, absolutely. I mean, you supposed to, but knowing the way the law is, that's kind of par for the course. You know, I mean, that's what's been happening. You know, for
it is. It's gonna keep happening. Too.
It's gonna keep on happening.
Some change.
Yeah, I mean, it's messed up that a life, you know, there's no value. A wall has more of a value than. Than a life. It's crazy. That's absolutely insane. But if you don't understand America the way I understand America, it's par for the course.
So Kanye don't sound so crazy when he say he want to dip.
Nope.
A lot of people do say that though. Yeah. But then they realize when they go elsewhere. I ain't talking about this year, 2020 been crazy, but years ago a lot of people was talking about they wanted to move, you know, away from the US because of just, you know, racist stuff or just inequality, whatever. But then they go other places and they realize it ain't, you know, it ain't just racist there. It ain't race. It's racist everywhere, but it's other problems that other countries are dealing with, you know, and they rather come back here.
Well, a lot of people are talking about going to Africa.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. And from my understanding, it's some nice, pleasant, peaceful places.
I have a very unique opinion about that.
Have you been?
I've never been.
Okay.
I would need to go to fulfill this opinion, like, fully. But I think because of the falsehoods that we've been told, so much falsehoods, Africa has been demonized a lot and has been talked negatively a lot. Mm-hmm. And I think that was for a reason.
Yeah.
I think that it may be very, very high quality of life in certain parts of Africa that we aren't supposed to know about, and mm-hmm. we're not supposed to discover. And that's why a lot of not so dark people live in Africa.
Yes.
Yeah. A lot more than we think.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. You know? Yeah, if you know about South Africa was controlled by the Dutch and the, come on, somebody help me out, by the Dutch and somebody else. But anyway, when apartheid ended and, you know, the people kind of took over or whatever, I mean, those houses was left empty and they're still there. You know, we call it Johannesburg. Johannesburg was a white only suburb. And when they got up, I mean, them houses over there looks absolutely amazing. I'm talking about stunning.
A white-only suburb.
A bedroom you could walk out onto your terrace and all of the walls collapse in. I mean, they was living over there like kings.
Well, I'll tell you seriously. This.
Let's go, y'all.
My husband wants to go.
Let's get out of here.
And he actually wants to get a residence there.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, I've had my thoughts and conflicts about it, but I'm getting closer to it. But when I found out that you can buy your house and don't have to pay taxes after you bought it, and when I found out...
She was all on board
it's
then.
Pay as you go. I said, won't me do it. I'm on my way because I'm so tired of these bills over here. I don't know what to do. So listen, we're going to take a break, and when we come back, we will be back with Mr. Ronald Campbell himself. So stay with us. So we're back with Mr. Ronald Campbell. But before we get to the questioning, I just want to thank my consistent co-host here. Okay? I just want to appreciate you guys live. Because there's a lot to be said about consistency. Now, I know for those who haven't seen Big Fella, you probably seen him. This should be your third time. Because he did the very first show with us. He is dependable. I want to let you know, just because you haven't seen him, that's a different question. I mean, different situation. But he's very dependable, and so is Deanna. So I want to thank you guys for being so dependable and loyal. Now, we got that out of the way.
Don't look at me like that. I'm dependable and loyal.
Oh, yeah, but that goes without being said.
I am your husband now. No,
that goes without being said. I have, you already know.
No, you already know people are listening for what you didn't say. But what she didn't say, girl. There's nothing about her husband.
I mean, my husband is consistent. Right, we've been married since 2009.
Yeah, I'm just telling you. I'm just saying.
Read it between the lines. Like, oh, she ain't mentioned her
pinch
husband.
Of salt. You know,
hey, you're right. People are so petty.
People love that pinch of salt now.
Because you don't be on that. No, we don't be on that. But he's thinking for the people that be on that type of stuff. We've been together since 2007. No, I'm going to go ahead and give him a background.
I shouldn't have said nothing.
Since 2007, we've been married since February 19, 2009. Now look at your watch and check the date. Okay, consistency. Proven. Now, to Mr. Campbell, I'm so happy that you came here today. I'm excited. You guys can follow him on TikTok. At Ronald Campbell 44. I've been enjoying his videos. He did a freestyle on TikTok to Megan Thee Stallion's song, Savage.
Bars.
So Snoop Dogg shared the video on Instagram, but he shared it after somebody else had tagged him. It's the page is called For Stoners Only. So they tagged him asking him to sign Mr. Campbell. And that was on Independence Day. That was July 4th that all of this had taken place, FYI. So Snoop shared it. So after Snoop shared it, it received 1,148,134 views.
Bars.
That's on top of it going viral on his own personal TikTok page, which is Ronald Campbell 44 again for you guys. And then the original page for Stoners Only has 501 views for the video. So it was just in divine order for him to go viral because that particular video didn't go viral. But he tagged Snoop. Snoop looked at it and shared it. But in case you haven't heard it, I'm going to play it for you.
Triple. I'm a savage. I got Pearl Maid cooking up the cabbage. She make an oxtail stew. I got to have it. I'm an old school player. I ain't average. Look, did 25 straight. I ain't tell on the soul. I could've, but shit, that ain't really how I roll. I'm a triple OG. I stick to the G code in my time.
So that's that. So
bars.
Man, what?
It was some bars.
You acted that out real good.
That oxtail. That oxtail got my bars. You're
right. It's not his bars.
Yeah, it's not my bars.
It was.
Acted to the
bars. Was your pantomizing, though. But the energy that you put into it.
But you still put it down, though.
Yeah.
The delivery was on point.
Exactly. It was. I mean, you did that. TikTok, from a content creator. Like, TikTok is not easy. Mm-hmm. That's why I don't really do it, because it's too much, too many moving parts, and that's just not my lane. If I feel moved to do it, then I will do it, but nah. So it takes some kind of talent and creativity to even be able to do that.
Right.
So let's not diminish the talent that you have.
Right.
I mean, because I've watched other videos and was cracking up. Like, he's crazy.
Hey, it's a lot of people don't write their own bars.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Most
people. So, you know, Drake. But, you know. Drake.
Shots fired.
Yes. We was talking out here, and you was telling us about that whole thing, the background story about, you know, kind of what happened. Because you went viral, but it's not your song.
Right.
So explain how all that background, you know, like with the person that you was talking to, you know, like how did all that happen? You know, I mean, like the communication between you and the individual who created the actual song.
Well, you know how TikTok work. You go on there, you find a song, and you do a skit to a rap.
Right.
So found the audio. Did the skit. Somebody posted. I'm not even the one that posted to Facebook. I think it went viral on Facebook first before the other pages.
Mm-hmm.
So it go viral. I didn't even know it went viral till days later. You know, I get a call from my family. You all over the place. I'm like, what's going on? I'm all over the place. Yeah, your TikTok. You know, so I'm like,
what? How long from you created it to you got that call?
It was out there probably about a week before I even knew it went viral.
Damn.
You know, so when it came on, I posted on my Instagram, and then I actually went to Snoop Page and said, thank you for posting my video. You know, that's all I said, thank you for posting my video.
Mm-hmm.
So then the gentleman that actually created the song went to my Instagram page and brought all his people over and was just dogging me out for like a whole day. You know, I didn't block him or nothing. I let him speak his piece, you know.
Block you off for what?
You know, because he put the sample out there. But since it went viral, he said that I should have tagged on my video his song, his
give him credits like, or whatever.
Give him credits.
Yeah.
But, you know, I just did a TikTok. It's like 100 people that did a TikTok to that same song. Mine just went viral. They liked it, you know.
Yeah, liked it better, yeah.
They like what I put together with the song, so.
Okay.
They basically came to the page and just bullied me for a day.
Okay.
But, you know, when I told them, you know, I had nothing to do with it. I just did a TikTok. You put the music out there, and he got off the page. Basically, he apologized at the end of the day.
Oh, that's good. Okay.
You know, but. Yeah. He said he wasn't mad, but at first he was upset. But when he figured out, you know,
right,
I just did the TikTok. I didn't even post it. He sort of just backed off. And,
right. So you didn't know. It wasn't like you was, oh, that, you know, you, this guy right here, I'm about to take his home because he's a nobody and stuff like that.
You didn't have no malicious intent.
Yeah. No, I didn't go to take nobody's shine. You know, I'm just.
You just liked it, the song. You liked it, you know, the word.
I'm a TikTok creator. So, you know, I go through and find the sounds and the stuff, and then I go in the lab and try to put something together, make somebody laugh.
Yeah,
you know, that's I'm just good. Here to make people laugh.
That's what's up.
So he wanted to be a Kardashian.
You irritate.
Yeah, the guy wanted to be a Kardashian.
He just wanted his credit.
The song went viral.
That's what happened.
Yeah,
he
wanted it to go viral.
Viral, right.
But he also wanted people to know who he was, because I would not have known that that was somebody else's song.
Exactly.
Had we not had this conversation.
Absolutely. And that's exactly why he's so doggone brilliant, because he executed it so well.
He bodied it.
I'm talking about he Michael Jordan, that boy.
He did. 23.
Hey, had me calling. Excuse me, I'm Mr. Campbell. Would you like to be on the podcast? Hi, babe. Oh. So, what was your initial goal behind starting your TikTok page?
Make people laugh.
Okay.
Just to be silly, make people laugh. I've been silly my whole life. So, if I could make somebody laugh, you know, get your laugh on.
So, was you the funny kid in the group, or was
I was always the class clown.
Oh, you were?
I was always getting in trouble in school, all that. Uh-huh. Yeah, I was always the class clown, or the silly person in the family, you know.
Okay. Kind of like the life of the party.
Yeah, kind of like the life.
And the party. Well, that's good. That's good. I mean, I'm looking at you, and you kind of got that swag, that hip-hop swag on you, guy. Yeah, how you hold on to
it. I'm 49, but you know, you got to keep a little bit. I mean, you know, can't totally grow up, you know what I'm saying?
Man, I
keep that silly side, you know.
You got to keep it. It helps you keep it youthful.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yes. Absolutely. Thanks. No, I mean, but you know, it's you living it, you know what I mean? You know what I'm saying? You living that
almost,
truth. Usually people your
else.
Age.
You know what I'm saying? I almost wore something else, but I'm like, man, I'm about to be
me. Don't be me.
Right, yeah. Right, exactly. Yeah. And that's good. And it makes you feel comfortable and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But you know, and I was thinking about that when I got older. What would I, you know, what kind of, where would I segue to? Would I still be wearing hoop shorts and, you know what I'm saying, a baseball cap at like 70? You know what I mean?
So, well, who cares?
Right, but that's what you're comfortable in.
Right, for sure. But you know, to see it in its true form is kind of uplifting.
It don't seem forced. Like,
right.
I've seen some older gentlemen, and it looks forced.
Yeah.
Like straight up and down Adidas tracksuit, head to toe. You know, like it's a little It's no like zipped all the way up type thing with the hat. You all know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, no,
right,
absolutely.
Right.
Yeah.
No, I got one for
it. It just looks forced.
It do. Yeah.
You
look
comfortable. Yeah.
It's you. Yeah. I feel it.
He ain't got them shorts on that almost look like pants.
Yeah.
What is that?
Capris.
I need my granddaddies. And he's not really a granddaddy. He's only 49. But I need my granddaddies to chime in and tell me what the hell is up with them shorts that's coming right above your ankles. What is that? Just wear some jeans. You ain't never seen that? They looking
that.
Like a Mr. Allen special. What is... Okay.
Yeah, right.
Anyway, did you ever foresee it going viral? Like, did you ever think about that?
No.
That's lit.
No. This is all amazing, really. You know, that it
was
went viral
one
like
repost?
That.
One post?
Because,
you know, sometimes people have to repost it.
No,
it was
one post.
That's even
so worse. So where the money at? Let's talk about the dollars.
I didn't get it. I guess whoever posted got the money.
My
All
gosh.
I got was a little bit of shine, and that was about it, sir. No, somebody else posted it. So, you
That's
know, they
crazy.
Got the viral. They got
right.
They got everything.
Well, hopefully, this is only the beginning.
Right.
Yeah.
You know, because it was entertaining to me, man.
Right.
I would love to, you know, see you doing other things, other videos. I would.
Oh yeah,
for
I would
it.
Love to. Have
I would
some
pay
props
for it.
If I had some props.
But,
or you know what? Or if listen though, a person like Snoop reposting it, that's big.
That's a big deal
because Snoop got millions of followers.
Right.
So if Snoop did it, you know.
So what if, let's say for hypothetically, Snoop called you and wrote a song of that, you know, saying of that ilk, would you act it out, rap it out, and all that stuff?
Oh yeah, that's for sure.
Let's see. Yeah, I like that.
I try to go home, act out anything. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I like doing this. It's relaxing to me.
Right, because you got a lot of artists that do have, you know what I'm saying, music that just on some old everyday, you know, bullshit that don't really make it to the final cut. You know what I mean?
Right.
That they probably would love to get out there some way, somehow on another platform or whatever the case may be.
Right,
you know what I mean?
Right.
But then I think that's a hell of a lane, you know. You know, I want my 10% though for that good idea that I just
He is crazy.
Look, I know how business work anyway. I know
but thank you. Hey, thank you. I'm and everybody is my witness.
That bodyguard, though. Hey. You know, I'll let your boy. That's all I'm saying.
Oh, you trying to get back into that?
No, not really.
You got serious real quick.
Just want to be on paper.
I'm not about to play with you.
It's principle. You never know.
Play with you.
You never know.
So do you have anything close right now that's getting to that point that you've done outside of
TikTok?
Yeah, no. Yeah, that other video? The first one?
Oh, I got some TikTok that's going viral right now that's very, very, very funny.
Spit it out. What's the one?
This one on there right now is like 15,000 likes on it.
Okay.
Just likes.
Yeah. Are you rapping on that one too?
No, I'm just doing I wish you could see it, but I'm doing another skit in the car just playing.
So do you have any other videos or any more bars outside of that video? Because I'm trying to hear some more bars, man. Because your delivery, I'm telling you, a lot of people can rap, but everybody don't have good delivery.
Yeah. Right about that.
You know, back in the day, maybe, you know what I'm saying? I even thought about writing a TikTok rap. You know what I'm saying?
It.
Something to be silly and goofy and just make people laugh, you know, so.
You got the eyes on you.
Yeah, yeah. They
so
on
you
me.
Might as well
they
try it out.
They on me everywhere.
Right. Right. You know what I mean?
This so this is the time.
It is.
Right, right.
Yeah.
Yeah, and his 10% too. We're all witnesses.
I'm not about to play with you. So I want to know, how did it feel when you realized that you went viral? Like,
that's what I was going to ask.
Oh, it was exciting.
I'm sorry.
It was exciting because, you know, you always want to be known for something. You know?
Like when you got that call.
When I got that call and they did the investigation, I'm like, wow, I went viral. How I go viral? You know, what video? I didn't even know what video it was. You know what I'm saying? Because I did so many TikToks. And it was exciting, you know?
Wow.
Then they told me I'm on Snoop page. I was on Mike Epps page.
What?
I think I was on Lil Duval's page.
What?
You know, my man, very talented, the dude that did the rap. You know what I'm saying? But
I mean, that hit me. Why don't y'all collab?
Right.
I wish I could reach out to him. I can't.
Reach out to him now. Yeah. Just go ahead.
Tell us.
I'm Ronald Campbell and Grandpa Homer. If you want to do some collab or put something together, I'm here. You know, much respect to you.
Yeah, I mean, that's how you got to do it. And you know, I don't want to get into a deep thing, but that's one of our biggest problems.
Yeah.
It's a community. You know, we want to be the all and everything, man. Just be, you know, play your part in the puzzle. Yeah, you know what I mean? Yeah. And so the whole picture can come together, you know. So, you know, reach out to that dude and, you know, do y'all thing, man. Because people loved it, dude. I genuinely loved it.
Yeah,
you know
me
what
too.
I mean?
Right. Me
genuinely.
Too.
From the first time I heard it, I'm like, that's what I'm talking. It's real.
It was
real. You know what I mean? And that's what probably resonated with you. It's like, man, this is real.
Yeah, when you hear it, it's like,
me
hey,
too.
Yeah.
Me
yeah.
too.
Yeah.
Me
you know
too.
What
me
I mean?
Too.
Like, come on.
So, there's a segment of my night that I spend about, I ain't going to say how long, but I spend some time online, on YouTube, looking at videos. And I would say out of that time frame, maybe 5%. Or less of the videos get a good emotion out of me, like bust out laughing or like, damn, that was crazy.
Yeah.
Yours is one of them, man.
Right.
Yours,
right.
It moved me, dog. I was like, hell, dog. I was like, this dude got bars.
I screamed.
You got a replay. It was real, this one man.
You
replay.
Hit him with the, you had
almost,
everything.
I almost snapped my knee when I did that.
Oh, my God.
I'm like, whoa, I felt that one right there.
Man, and you low-key hit a couple little blocks there. You was like, oh. Look at all
he on, did man. It. He did that.
You got any grandkids or kids or anything like that?
Yeah. I got five kids.
What was your family reaction to it? What was their reaction?
They know I'm silly, so you know what I'm saying? I give them so many TikToks and so many videos. They just know I'm silly. You know?
What was their reaction to your exposure, like to you blowing up like that?
It was excited for me, you know? Nice. Like, where's this going to go? You know, I just
didn't
know where it was going to go, you know? Yeah, I was out. People like, oh, you got the money. You got some money.
How was that?
No, I didn't get no money.
They don't understand, like, that don't mean money. All your friends
looking at you funny, you know?
Hey, even when you do, tell them, I ain't got no money.
Yeah, you're right.
You're right. They'll be lining up.
Views don't always equal money, so that's something
to... That's how they promote it, though. Huh? You know what I'm saying? That's how they promote it. Like, yeah, if you go viral, that's how it's promoted. If you get this many likes, or if you get this many followers, if you get this many views, then somebody gonna send you a check. You're gonna get a blue check mark, and you're gonna be official out here. That's how they promote it. I mean... So child. I can see why people was like, so where the money at?
Listen, I went viral for trying to help our former mayor. I got talked about, attacked. I got ignorant mail, all type of stuff. What I did not get was a check or a blue check. I didn't get neither one of those. You know what I'm saying? And I was really being sincere. Instead, I turned out to be a side chick and all type of ridiculous
mess. Yeah, it was really salacious, man. I couldn't... When that news lady called me and what was actually out there, what they actually printed in the newspaper was... I mean, it was what I said, but it was grossly out of context. And that's when I kind of discovered that what the media actually does, you know. And then that morning, we was woken up by Channel 7 knocking on our door.
That's wild. I had my bonnet on. I ain't had time for Channel 7. Yeah.
And I'm like...
I had to get back with real Porsche talk.
I'm babe. Oh, I mean, she was, you know, the wife, man, she was pretty, you know, she was pretty bummed about it because she was kind of like, dang, I brought all this heat on you. You know what I mean? Yeah. That's not what I was trying to do at all. You know, I didn't mean to bring anything towards your direction. And it was a lot. I mean, I got a lot of sympathy. Apparently, I'm a battered man. You see what I'm saying? So, yeah, y'all kind of got to be careful how you expose yourself and family, because I mean it's a good thing for that individual, but the family, man, it's other repercussions. I mean, because it can go left. I mean, I understand what attention does.
Definitely, but fighting for the right side is always going to get resistance. And just so y'all know, I will be continuing the fight with Kwame Kilpatrick, and I don't care how you feel about it. So that's that. Right. But back to Mr. Campbell.
Right.
So are you looking to act or anything like that? I could see you doing some acting.
Yeah, you'd be real good.
Oh, yeah, I would love to get into something like that. Mm-hmm. That would be exciting.
Yeah, you need to do that. You need to pursue that.
Try to go into different roles. I really try to in my head when I come up with the content. You know, I try to get into the role, you know.
I see. Yeah. You do that well. That's why
I'm seeing so many roles that I'm thinking of that you could play. Like so many.
Yeah, and then I got the goofy look. You know, I got the eyes.
You said the goofy look.
I can make somebody laugh just by the, you know, my face, you know. So get your laugh on.
You are a mess. What you're doing is a blessing because laughing keeps people young.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Laughing keeps people going. When they want to cry, instead they laugh. Yeah. I mean, because the first time I know how it went viral. Because the first time I saw it, I hollered. I tagged my husband. I tagged my friends. It was crazy. I was like, did y'all see this? They was like, hell no, that's crazy.
Keep going, because I definitely sent about 10, 12 people and watched it some more.
Yeah,
my homie, me and my homie was driving, and that's how you know it's funny. Because you know, you don't touch a black man's radio at all.
Never.
And when you do that, you know, attention, sir, something is going on right now. Yeah. And Greg sat back, and he was like, dog, man. Look at this. And I'm driving, so you know it got to be important. Man, and it was this. I'm sitting there just the whole time like, Jesus Christ, dog. This dude is getting it. You know what I mean? But it's the energy that you put into it. I mean, that's why it's like, you can be that, you know, that character in that movie. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. All the time. Every movie, the same character doing the same exact thing, you know?
I mean, I can think of a lot of actors that have the same role
in every movie. Yep.
It's so funny.
I like it, man. I love it.
I appreciate it.
I mean, I just want to give you my encouragement and say keep going, because not only can it bubble for you, I'm believing that it's going to work out for you, but you give encouragement to others. You know what I'm saying? Right. Because people have to understand when it comes to creativity It's not, and you're not old, so that's not what I'm saying. But this is not about an age thing. You know, at any age, if you are creative and you can capture attention, go for it.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Go for it.
And don't be worried about your views. Don't get hard up about your likes. Just keep going. Because, you know, it's the consistency that wins in the end. People that spike like this, boom, they go up quick. A lot of times they go down quick. When you put in that work, you've been working at it 5-10 years, and then you pop, you're more than likely to stay up there for a long time. You know what I mean? So never get discouraged about things like that. And I'm talking to myself too, because sometimes I'd be like, I'm just, you know, I put in all this work, and then people just don't appreciate it. It's a lot.
It's a life.
Yeah. It's a lot, and it's a lifestyle, and it takes commitment. It does. But there's always somebody who's going to come and encourage you. You're going to have people that stick with you, because I know I have them, and they're consistent. They're always commenting. They're always liking. They're always, you know what I'm saying? And that's what you do it for. So anybody got anything else to say? Y'all want to shout out your social media pages, because we're about to get up off the air.
I just want to say, man, again, I enjoyed your video, man. I'm going to get your information, because I'm in the process of writing a play.
Oh,
and okay. Like I said, I can see you in at least one role.
Yes, sir.
So,
yeah, so writers, you already know who it is. You know.
Get at me.
Get at this man.
Tell them where you're at one more time. Tell them where they can find you.
Oh, you can find me on TikTok. My name is Ronald Campbell 44. Go check it out. I got some funny material right now that's going viral. And thanks for having me.
You got an IG?
Oh yeah, I got an IG, but I got most of my TikToks is on my Facebook.
Right, but so people, because a lot of people generally go, yeah.
It's the same. Yeah, Ronald Campbell 44 on Instagram.
Got you.
Okay. Okay.
Yep.
Good.
Anything you want to say, Deanna?
I was excited about this. I wanted to meet him. I did. He bodied it. I was excited. Shout out to you.
Appreciate it.
I don't even need no shout outs today. Shout out to you.
Appreciate it.
Shout out to DRE Project. Anything you want to say, baby?
No, I don't.
All right, well, I just want to let you know that I appreciate your consistency.
Oh,
and I love your chocolate skin.
Okay. And I love you too, baby.
I can't wait to rub on it and do Lord some other Jesus. Things. That
What segment is this?
So listen, if you guys like my content, remember, every 2 weeks, the show comes back. The next time that we're back, we'll be doing Battle of the Sexes. Please look out for Love and Entanglements podcast next Saturday at 5 o'clock. We will be doing that. Check us at RockyRoadMedia.com for all your updates, info, advertisement, whatever. I got some merch. That's how you're going to keep up with me. You can find me through social media, whatever. Check out RockyRoadMedia.com. Thank you for stopping by and giving us your time. We love you. I love you. I love us. And we are out.